Hi YouTube, this is Ceramic85. Today I want to show you what I came up with for my LPG, liquid petroleum gas injection kit. For those of you that have a LPG injection kit, you know that you need the warm water of the motor to evaporize the liquid petroleum gas. And to speed that whole process up, I bought a heater from the junkyard. It has three glow plugs in it. I put it right in between the engine and the evaporizer for the LPG gas. The bad thing about it, since I got it from the junkyard, the glow plugs are all dead. So I ordered some new ones and I'm going to replace them today. So the water runs from the engine, from the water pump, through my extra heater, into the evaporizer, out of the evaporizer, into the cap to the heater core, back out into the engine compartment, and then right back into the motor. The extra heater is not only for the evaporizer, but in winter time also, if it's really cold out, it helps to heat up the inside of the car real quick. So far the plan. All three glow plugs have a total amperage of 30 amps. That's why I used a thick wire that I ran right under this rubber lip over there to the battery. On the other side of the engine compartment, it comes right out here. It's the red thick wire you can see. For safety reasons, I put a 50 amp fuse in between the power line, and with this relay, I can turn on and turn off the heater later. The relay is connected to a switch in the inside of the car, so that way I can turn off the heater at any time. I'm gonna show you the switch real quick. Obviously it's in the inside of the truck, and I put it right here next to the LPG gasoline switch. Here you see the glow plugs that I bought off eBay for 5 euros a piece. This is what they look like. On this end you connect the positive wire. The other end goes into the water and hopefully heats it up. I use a 12 millimeter extra long socket to go right over it. It's a little hard to get it out. It's all old and rusty. Now, as I take out the old glow plug, I place the bottle under it to catch all the liquid that comes out. Not only to reuse it, but to not spill it to the environment. As the old one is out now, I put the new one right back in. I try to tighten it up pretty good so it doesn't come out later. When the motor is running, there's a little pressure on it, so we don't want to spill it out. I installed the three new glow plugs, and now I'll put the wires on. Here you can see my setup. This is the positive wire that comes to the first glow plug, and then there's two more wires connecting the other two glow plugs. The negative wire comes from the frame from the heater right there, and it goes all the way over here and connects to the frame right there. Now I will do a little test with one plug connected. I will turn on the engine and then we will see how many amps one plug is drawing and if it's working right. Now, as you can see, one plug is drawing about 19.3 amps, which is a little bit more than I thought it would. So I will stay with two plugs connected for now, and I'll see if it makes a difference in starting up the vehicle and warming it up. As soon as I have results about how much gasoline I'm saving with this new setup, I will get back to you with another video. Well, thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed. to ramigate 5, signing out.